Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Chief House, P.O. Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
Now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, ask an alms. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, "Look on us." And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter said, "Silver and gold have I none. What shall I have give I thee? In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked, and entered with them in the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. And they knew it was he who sat down at the beautiful gate of the temple. And they were filled with a wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. I said, a teacher is a channel. And you see, for proper flow, a tank must be raised very high if you are going to have water to run down. If you just put a tank on the floor and you expect water to flow out of it and run to the house, it will be a very difficult assignment. But when you lift it high, and that's why we call it overhead tank, then water can start coming down at a very fast speed. The life of a teacher must be raised high, 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 spiritually above his own spirit. Peter said he's crippled, and you see the situation of these children. Some of them, their characters have been crippled from birth. As soon as they were born, they started doing wrong things. Some of them started stealing, some started abusing one another, some started fighting. And some of them learned lies from the very beginning. Nursing mothers will testify that there is no particular teacher externally that teaches a child how to bite your best when feeding. There is a deformity right from birth. So this man was deformed from birth. And because of that, his life was reduced to ordinary begging. And we see them on the street, we name them, call some of them Agboro, call some of them Amrobas, you call some of them Harlots, you call some of them so many, 419 and so on. These are the result of deformity from past. You find them around motor parks, public areas, they learn how to speak foolishly. And the group that have formed occultic groups on our campus. This deformity came right from beginning. But I saw some wisdom here. The temple gate is not the only place to beg. In fact, I hardly find beggars around us. Find them around motor parks, on major streets, and so on. But why was this man positioned on the way into the church? Something told him, even if I cannot be healed of this deformity from birth, at least somebody who enters the church will be a merciful person, can give me some money. And they carried him there daily. So one of the afternoon, Living Bible said 3 p.m., 4 p.m. Peter was going there and John to pray. And the man gave his usual signs and expectations. But then Peter said to him, look on us. Teachers, is it possible for you to teach without students seeing you? Look on us. No teacher is hidden. No teacher can pretend in a class so much that the student will not be able to know who the teacher is. No. Look on us. That is the message. Whether you tell them or not, they are looking on you. And Peter was careful to use his words. He didn't say, look at us. Look at us would have just been an ordinary sight. But when they say, look on us, it's like looking with an intention to copy. Looking with an intention to follow. Looking with an intention to emulate. Look on us. If you don't know how to get out of this problem, look on us. If you don't know how to receive your healing, look on us. If you don't know how to be cured of this deformity, look on us. And for a Christian teacher, if the students are going to be looking on you, they will not only get mathematics, they will not only get English, they will not only get physics and all the subjects. You see, this man's expectation was just Naira and Kobo. But Peter said, as you are looking on me like this, I will give you 1 Naira, 2 Naira, 5 Naira, that you have been receiving from people that has never changed your life. As you look on me, I will go to the root of your problem. A teacher is supposed to bring healing to his students as he goes to the root of the problem. Look on us. And you see, the students are being good, they didn't copy your speech, copy your dress, copy your mannerism. As they look on you, they are already following. I was in secondary school, we had a teacher that used to teach us French, but he was a drunk. This man would drink and get drunk, and then he would enter the class, and the whole class would be smelling. So we used to enjoy his lessons, those of us who didn't like French, because each time he came, we were ready to misbehave, because we know we also feel punishment. So as he was entering, we will laugh and jump through the window and make noise. Then he will go and give an issue in the dining room that our class should not eat. We should all wash plates. Of course, we accepted that. Why were we not behaving the same way with all other teachers? As we look on him, we didn't see something to help us. And there was going to be a surprise package. This man never expected that this is problem that has reduced him to begging can find a solution. He was expecting money. And Peter said, silver and gold we don't have. We don't expect too much from civil servants. Once they don't pay, we know there's no money. But whether they pay or not, a Christian teacher has something. The silver and gold we don't have, but we have something. Something that we do for you what money cannot do. That we have. And none of us should go to a class empty. Even if you get an empty, your spirit should be loaded. You must have something that can get to the root of this children's problem. I'm just calling them children. You know, some students are older than your age. So you see, when they get to what you call school, their characters change. You see somebody who is a father-in-law just behaving as if before he brought in the issue of silver and gold, they have already arrested my attention. Said, look on me. Then he said, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Will God ever use you to bring healing to the crippled carcass? Tired, you don't know what to do. That's what the spirit children are saying, look, just help us. They say we have done our best at home. There's no change. And I hope you know the children spend more time with teachers than the parents. Nowadays they are giving out the whole lesson. If that leaves home 8 in the morning and he's coming back around 4-5. How many hours does he spend with the parents? So if there is something bad for the child to copy, he has enough hours to be bad. And yet, if there is something good for the child to copy, there is enough time for him to copy. Look on us. Whether you like it or not, the students are looking on you. Now what did this man get by looking at Peter? He said, Peter then grabbed him by the hand and raised him up. and a suit. With his suit, I thought he would take the road to his house, or he went to the temple. Who taught him to go to the temple? Peter said, look on us, and as they looked at him, they were going to the temple. So where will he also go? The temple. When a child decides to look at you, where will you lead him to? And I don't know. He started dancing and jumping and walking about and praising God and singing. He got double portion that day. He got physical healing and he got eternal salvation. And there is no record of this man's sliding. What happened to him that day stayed forever. When a student decides to watch your life, what will he get? So I told you that a future is a channel. Something must flow. Either correct water or polluted water. Something must flow. That is why God has decided to first of all call us and purify this water in us, that as we get home, we get to our various institutions, what will be flowing will not be polluted. I hope you got your class with your pulpit. Your department is your pulpit. And you know that ministry among students, if you are a teacher, is very, very convenient. You don't need to spend extra for follow-up. Just as you are going to your normal duty, you meet them. And you know that students believe it is more than their parents. Even as I am sitting here as a teacher, your child doesn't believe you. He believes another teacher more than you. If you show him something at all, he says, no, that's not how Atira told us. Now, so you have a group of people that believe you much more than we, the parents, of what is flowing out of your life. Look on us. As he's looking at you, you know, the first thing we see is the external. Is that right? The first thing the student will see is the external. Even by the way you dress. If he finds you smoking, if he finds you sending him to go and call girls for you, as he's looking on you like this, he discovered that each time you are speaking with those girls, you are arranging special extra lessons only for female students. The rest are watching. Then we also watch. If you are there who always insists on the morning assembly that there must be at least a small period that God will speak to the children before they enter class, they know. Something there for must happen to us. So that I go, it is going to be alright. Correct water will start flowing out. 2 Kings chapter 2, the story of Elijah and Elisha, a handover. Let's just begin from verse 9. And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of the spirit be upon me. And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I am preaching from thee, it shall be so unto thee, but if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass, as the sea went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire, and horses of fire, and parted both asunder. And Elijah went up by a wild wind into heaven. Elisha saw it, and he cried, my father, the chariots of Israel, and the horsemen thereof. And he saw him no more, and he took hold of his own clothes, and rent them in two pieces. He took up also the mantle of Elijah, that fell from him, and went back, and stood by the bank of the Jordan. You must carry something from here. Elisha took something that fell from Elijah. That was what was going to become the brook of his ministry. And when people look on him, that thing they took will affect the people. May we have no reason to go empty without taking something. We must take something. Now, but how are we going to tell that? It came from his request. You know, he was given a blank check. They said, now ask what I will do for you. He didn't ask for increment of salary. He didn't ask for promotion. He didn't ask to be made a principal. He said, there is an amount of life of God in you that I want twice that amount. He said, well, you have asked a hard thing. But if only you will concentrate, you will get it. And concentration is very important in this day. One of the distractions will be cold. You may feel cold so much that your ears may even block. Another distraction may be the market behind me. I'm not sure everybody is here. Some will still be going around. Have you not finished frying yam? They told Elisha, if you concentrate, you will get it. So he made sure that nothing came between him and his master. And finally, when the matter was taken, he saw it. He saw when the matter was taken. And he shouted and said, I have seen you, I have seen you, I have seen you, I have seen you. And that's how the man became loaded with what he took. Verse 16. They said unto him, behold now, there be with thee the seven 16 strong men. Let them go with thee and seek the master, lest peradventure the spirit of the Lord and taking him up and cast him upon some mountain or into some valley. And he said, yea, I mean, ye shall not send. And when they told him till he was ashamed, he said, send. They sent there for 50 men, and they sought his face, but found him not. And when they came again to him, for he tarried at Jericho, he said unto them, did I not say unto you, go not? And all those were instructions to try and push him off, for he knew what he was doing. So verse 19, that's where we are going. We now came to the city. The Bible said, the men of the city said unto Elisha, behold, I pray thee, the situation of this city is pleasant. Now, Which of your universities is ugly? I want to look at Kogi State University and the building is beautiful. Situation on every campus is pleasant. So the structures are not the problem. Almost every institution, even right from primary school, local government education authority, you find continuous refurbishing of the school. Sometimes we remove the old things, they are putting new ones, they are putting new things and everything. The situations of our institutions, the structures are fine. But they say the water is not and the ground is by. What flows out of this school is the bad thing. Discussing barrenness of character. There's nothing wrong with the classrooms, or departments, the administrative block, nothing. The situations of institutions are fine, the structures are fine. But the people said, but the water that comes out of this city is poison. They say, oh my Lord, as you can see, the situation is fine. But it is here people learn how to dress habit. The situations are fine, but this is where court is working very. The other day, some student came from another university to another university in the afternoon and shook a student's head and went back. The problem was not with the structures. Actually, the water that flows from this institution is very contrary to the structure that you can see standing so fine. And I think most of the institutions have 10 campuses. Is it correct? It is possible for us to teach without students seeing us. Maybe teaching would have been easier, but it's not possible. It must be us. Something must flow from us. And in this meeting, God is doing everything to give us pure water to take home. So that when we take our positions, our institutions, those lives that are committed to us, they will find pure water to drink. And when they drink, two things will happen. It will bring healing generally, and it will remove barrenness. So the ground is barren, and there are all manner of diseases. When Elisha heard those complaints that you are hearing now, see, the right approach is for you to say, I will resign. There is no way to handle that matter. Resignation is not the answer. The answer is for you to cut correct water. And when you go, lift your tank very high so that it can flow at a high velocity. So when Elisha heard, he said, verse 20, bring me a new cruse and put salt there. You know, salt is a preservative. word of God is true. It prevents rottenness. If we carry it into our classes, something will happen. And they brought it to him, and he went forth unto the spring of water and cast the salt in there and said, thus says the Lord, I have healed these waters. There shall not be from thence any more death on barren land. So the waters were healed on this day, according to the saying of Elijah, his prophet. In a short prayer of holding God, but I must find good water. I must carry salt to take home and cast into the spring. The spring flows. And you know, all our institutions are a pool. The spring of water. I don't know how it happens, but you just find that there's a uniformity of behavior. Something that is happening very far in one school somewhere, you just find it again everywhere. It just multiplies. It's a ring. Flowing very fast. If we only hear the problems of the schools and have no solution to offer, we have not done well. We are here to report the situation of God and then carry solution back home. And they brought him salt. Is it not the salt that they have been using to cook before? Eh? It's a different kind of salt. Why didn't it work with them? When something is wrong with the pipe, it won't flow. When the right man handled the common salt, it became a solution. Something must happen to the teacher first. When the teacher is healed, his class, his department will yield. When the teacher is healed, then what looks ordinary will no longer be common. Ordinary statements will now carry weight. God bending on us very heavily. Whatever is going to happen to those lives under our care in various institutions must be done with us. This meeting I look at as a delegate conference. It's like those students in your school sent you, say, come for us. Provost, come for us. PC, come for us. Physics master, come for us. When you return, we know we'll find good drinking water. How terrible will it be to go back and say, well, my pipe is blocked so I don't flow. So Elijah became the solution. Christ who had been in that city before. Prophets were living in that city before. You are not the only teachers from your various institutions. But because they have one God who can be the answer, can never be. When they don't have that thing, the only thing they resolve is expulsion. So send them away. If you send them away, there's still be a problem in their head. God make me a solution. Give me that salt, let me also carry. The salt that brought healing to the whole city and became the cure for barrenness, I want to carry it. I don't know how long this city has been waiting, but finally the solution came. You bring good news to your institutions as you return. That as you return, cult is to find the impossible number. As you return, even your fellow teachers, who used to tell them together, you won't pass the exam on to do something, they will find it difficult, impossible to wait. Brother Gilead used to tell us a story when he was a teacher. And this stream of clean water was flowing. How his co-lecturers made trouble with him. He said, we know you are spoiling the market. May each one of you go and spoil market. Don't be the good group of sinners. Go and spoil market. Hearing new stories, I said, I didn't know you are a useless man like this. You just went and came by, you are mad. Then we know you are spoiling market. But to behave like a Levite who saw a high man and he just passed by, said, me, I don't want trouble. When it is time for the Bible, God knows how to do it. It is time. It's time. If not now, when? If it took only one Elisha to bring healing to that city, I think you are enough for your various institutions. And God honored Elisha's effort. The result was not just for 1 week. They said from that day forward, forever, the cities were healed. We don't want temporary results. We want what God will do, and the result will last forever. You see, before Elisha came to this point, something happened to him first. God did something in his heart. Even when he was given a blank check with your request, he knew what to ask. For the sake of this new move, the grace of God will increase upon our lives. Look on us. When the people look at Peter, he was healed. When the city looked at Elisha, there was healing. But if something is wrong with our own eyes, and that's the problem, if there will be no flow. We pray this morning. are going to hold God individually. You are standing on behalf of your institution. And you are saying, Lord, I am here as a delegate. I must not go back as a disappointment to my institution. I guess there are even some that the school sponsored them. They say, look, the situation of our school, we can't handle it. Go, whether you will come back with an answer. The situation of the city, the campuses are all right. Structures, no problem. But there is pollution. And Elijah stepped into Cassidy. That was the end of it. They go find you an answer to return. Let's pray. It's not a hidden ministry. People must look on you. Children must see you. They must examine your life, and as they watch you, what are they seeing? Let God be gracious to us to first of all deal with personal pollution. Drug addicts are waiting. Homosexuals are waiting. They say, who will deliver me from this? Exam malpractice is high on the increase. Who will change this situation? You hear lecturers saying, as far as I'm in this institution, if this girl does not bow to my request, she will never graduate. And the girl is there for 10 years. Who will change this situation? This thing gave Elijah no rest. He said, look, I must not return to Jericho empty. I must carry the solution. The ordinary salt in the hand of Elijah became something. Tell God you must not go empty. You must put salt in your hand. Something must flow. Something must flow. Something must flow. Pray also that you will not be a leaking tank. After the Lord has brought you and filled you, then you leak away. No! Did the Lord find you as an answer? In the name of Jesus. Now listen. In the days of Balaam, there was pollution in the camp of Israel. And the people gathered and they were crying. Then one bold sinner, he went and brought a woman to lie with her in the camp. And the people were already crying for the trouble they had. And then one young man, I think he's in heaven, he went and got a davadin. He said, I cannot be here and pollution will come. So he lifted up the davadin and struck these people. And that was the end of it. As we go, I pray that God will help your life to change the situation. The devil will no longer find it convenient to operate. In Jesus' name, prayer. So we thank you this morning. We thank you for this privilege. Counting on us as a solution to our decaying educational system in Nigeria. Nowadays, if a student comes up with a good result, nobody believes anymore. They say it must have been a polluted result. Righteousness has become cast. There is barrenness of truth. If there was any time we needed you, Lord, it's now. But Lord, as we look at your word, there's no good to be magic. We take an Elisha who prepared himself and got what it takes to make a change. And then he became the answer. These few days that you have taken us away from our environment and you have brought us to this lonely place to incubate upon our lives, we are asking that your efforts will not be wasted. Each one of us, whether as a class teacher or HOE or the head of institutions, we will return, O God, as a solution in the name of Jesus Christ. Those barrenness that we saw before and we kept quiet, change the attitude. That now we will be ready with salt to cast wherever there is rottenness. We will behave like Phinehas. We will be bold to tell people to look on us. And as they look at our lives, they will find healing. Father, we beg you, don't run this meeting at a loss. Begin with us. Some of us are people who even made repentance difficult for our spirit. The They say, but our teacher is like this. Change our testimonies in Jesus' name. Help us, oh God, as we return to our campuses, even our primary schools, we find a reason to rejoice that something has happened to our teacher. Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.